Dector, one of my favorite people that I've known for, dear God, over 20 years, the Guardian of Chaos, Big Daddy! And here to conduct Big Daddy, this just in, he still has the whitest teeth in professional wrestling. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to the stage, Kurt Adonis!
Daddy was involved in one of the most hilarious segments you're ever going to
and the pride that I have in my heart as I pointed to that screen and told everybody in that room, look, I know him. I know him. And for one day, that was actually positive. I've always told Big Daddy that if I ever had children, that it would be the matches that we had together that would be the first ones that I would show them. Because they meant that much to me. I look at Big Daddy with the highest level of respect. A mentor, a friend, somebody who showed me the road, showed me good times, laughed beyond words for many, many, many years. He used to be the guardian of chaos. Today, he's known as chaos. But tonight, there's one more adjective to describe this special man, and that is New England Pro Wrestling Hall of Famer. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the one and only Big Daddy!
Samoans, man, we had the
time of our lives. Pehea oe, melehini, kahentane, mahalo. To all my Samoan brothers.
You spoke Anjo?
My friends and I in college, thank you, Real Deal. We decided to talk ourselves in to becoming professional wrestlers. So we showed up at the Quest facility in Orange, Connecticut, where I ran into tough Tony Altomare, Rob Altomare, Paul Romo was there, Tony Garea, Tony Atlas, David Schultz, and Mario Mancini. The training, although standard for the 1980s, was a secret chore for me. I didn't tell anybody, and I'm not telling anybody until right now. The only one that knows about this is Mario Mancini. I had been in a significant accident where I broke both my ankles in six places. I broke my lower back. I couldn't walk for over a year and a half, and I was in a wheelchair for 6 months. I never told anybody because I bounced back and I was in incredible shape. And I showed up at the wrestling school where Mario Mancini was one of the trainers with Tony Altomare. And he whipped my ass from pillar to post. Needless to say, I didn't tell anybody about those injuries. I was only 16 years old at the time of those injuries. I showed up at the wrestling school at 20 years old. I got the term. I started a career in the Department of Corrections. It lasted 25 years, and I started a family. But the passion and desire to not completely let go of my childhood image of pro wrestling stayed with me as a constant throughout my adult life. I trained with the legendary strongman Kenny Fontano, Iron Mike Sharp, briefly, and I mean briefly, with Mario Mancini. A close friend and I traveled with the Samoan SWAT team, Samoa and Rikishi, as a favor to learn the business and to have some fun in WCW. Because Michael Hayes, the Road Warriors, Ron Simmons, Sting, Lex Luger, wow, the desire and passion struck again. No matter the injuries, no matter my limitations, and again, nobody knew, and I wasn't going to be soft, and I wasn't going to tell anybody. Not even Mancini. I changed my approach, and I transformed into the character, the guardian of chaos, Big Daddy.
That's right.
At that point, I had trained as much as I could. I perfected a handful of bumps as talent. It was solidified in my mind as pro wrestling's next Captain Lou Albano. I sent countless demos to World Wrestling Federation, Dusty Rhodes, Harley Race, NWA, and AWA, all the top territories, and even went up to Titan Towers to deliver my promos to Vincent Kennedy McMahon. Now, earlier tonight, I had dinner with Mario and Paul and Sergeant Murray and the Four Horsemen, Duke the Dumpster, Drosy, and everybody else. And you know what I have here? I have a letter from J.J. Dillon from 1994 when I went up to Titan Towers and got thrown out of Titan Towers. Not the first time. Not the first time. So I had dinner with J.J. Dillon tonight. And I brought this.
Love you, brother.
I love you too, Joel. And JJ said, sure. Go ahead. You can talk about this tonight. More or less what this says right here, and I know Paul Roman and Mario Mancini and all the guys in the World Wrestling Federation and World Wrestling Entertainment know what this means. Claim rejected. That's what it means. Sincerely, JJ Dillon, Vice President of World Wrestling Federation Talent Administration. We appreciate your patience and can anticipate our written response after we've had an opportunity to review your correspondence. Needless to say, at 56 years old, here I am. Thank you, J.J. Dillon. Paul Roma, I know you're back in a moment. This is the sign, Roma. I love that man, Paul Roma. And I love that man, Mario Mancini.
sign up, get that on camera. Because he's constantly kayfabing me wherever I go. It's eating big pops me, former kayfabes me. But guess what? I love every moment.
Oh, shit.
I certainly tried kicking in the door. It's been all from wrestler to manager to broadcaster, ring announcer, ring crew, ticket seller, promoter, flyer anchor, and sweeper of floors. My locker room was usually very crowded by the mop bucket and the mop. Tonight, I thought we were going to hold my induction in the phone booth because there would be plenty of room. I did everything from soup to nuts, as Mancini would say, with emphasis on the nuts. Fast forward to my mid and late 30s, I started seeing some success, and when I met most of you young men here, I was already an old man while you were trying to be stars. Except for maybe Ron Zombie. He might be older than me, I'm not sure. He's certainly better looking than I am. So is Romeo Rosselli. Rosselli, keep your hands off my wife. Keep your hands off my wife, Rosselli. Listen, I understand you're a good-looking guy. I get it. Listen, fans, Romeo Rosselli, they don't call him the heartthrob for nothing. I mean, where's he, Antonio Thomas? He's here, so stay away from my wife, Thomas. Stay away from my, look at the hair on these guys. You can't make it up. This is not in the script either. Look, now they're sitting on both sides of the now. Antonio Thomas and Romeo Rosselli, the WWE heartthrobs, standing next to my wife, Dark. Don't be embarrassed, sweetheart. This is what the girls on the road called rats used to wish for.
Big Daddy!
I didn't do it.
I didn't hear you yet.
I learned, I listened, I studied, I made the most of it. I had testicular fortitude. At one time or another, I have crossed paths with several of you here. I am so humbled to have been allowed to work with so many legends, talented athletes, young superstars and performers. All of you in different ways helped me live my dream, and I'll never forget you for that. I never worked for Vince McMahon. But the memories of what you can accomplish in this business and never giving up is what can never be taken away. I've been avalanched by Bundy. That's why I can't see, and I'm going to name drop everybody. Because he didn't think I was going to name drop, but I'm going to name drop because that's all I have. I've been avalanched by Bundy, choked out by Slaughter, headbutted by Superfly, sockled by Mr. Foley, axe-handled by Kurt Kowalski, danced with Rikishi, was up by the Dudleys, squashed by Yokozuna, I teamed with Anvil, John Diamond, I was busted open by Terry Funk, I bled with Zombie, Curry, Kurt, Homicide, Bulls Mahoney, I was bitch slapped by Sonny and Velvet Sky. I was licked by the Bushwhackers. I felt the wrath of Jake and the Snake. I took over office in my biggest honor in my career for the legendary Bruno Sammartino. And I even raised an eyebrow with The Rock. It was one hell of a ride. Here at the age of 56. I could be the oldest person in the room. I get a little lost here, folks. JJ, you're always saying to me, JJ, all right, fans, feel so blessed to have been a small part of a brotherhood of professional wrestling. It's hard to explain. It's even harder to understand for fans and outsiders, but that's what makes it priceless. That's what makes it so special. Relationships, the road, the stories, the anticipation of performing live. A feeling, in my opinion, no drug could ever match. It's euphoric, it's timeless, it's in your blood, it's in your DNA. It's like a member of the secret society. Loved and hated at the same time. You figure out, and something pulls you back. I walked away more times than Brett Favre. I'd like to thank my Paradise Alley family. In closing, I'd like to thank the love of my life, Dar, my daughter, Nicole, my son-in-law, Gio, my amazing granddaughter, Mila, and fans, friends, fellow inductees. I can't tell you how much this has meant to me in my career. God bless you all. Travel safe, and I hope to see you again someday.